G'day friends and welcome to another one of my videos. Now today we're going to be talking about custom white balance. So what's the big deal about custom white balance and how do you go about setting it up on your Canon M50 or any Canon camera for that matter? If you want to find out what the big fuss is all about, well then stick around. So what's the big deal about setting the white balance? Well, the thing is, especially in these sort of cameras like the M50, you don't get those fancy log profiles where you can sort of record in a very flat type of format. And so I guess fixing the white balance after is really hard to do. And so it's best to set the white balance before you start recording, especially in an environment where the actual, I guess, light is gonna be changing more often than none. In my office, I've got a window there. So depending on the way the clouds in the sky are, you find the situation where it's getting brighter and darker depending on like the conditions. So setting the white balance helps to keep that under control and you get a nice sort of steady looking color. So, it's really important. Now, secondly, the other question that I always used to have as a technoramus, of course, is why do they call it white balance and we use a gray card to actually correct the white balance? So apparently it's just the way that the camera works. In order for it to capture a good range of color, for everything from very dark to very white, it relies on a 18% gray, color in order for it to stabilize at a good level. So that's why your white balance card is a gray card, which is kind of cool and confusing. But anyway, after I did a bit of research, I found that out. So there's plenty of those gray cards all over the market. I'm going to use my little passport card. So let's get back in the office and work out how to set the right white balance for the M50. So let's go back in the office. Okay, so we're back in the office now, and if you can hear some loud chirping, it's some annoying Indian miners outside the window, which just won't be quiet. Anyway, what I've done is I've set up some test subjects in front of the camera. To the right-hand side, I've got some natural light coming in through the window where those noisy birds are, and I've also got an LED light above it illuminating the rest of the table. So the first thing that I have to do is take a photograph of my 18% gray card in order to have my sample to use it as my custom white balance. When you take this photograph, you have to make sure you're on manual mode because in automatic mode, it does not let you sort of change the white balance. So just that's one tip. If you can't find the white balance selector, it's because you're in auto mode. Switch it over to manual mode and you'll be able to see it. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to try to fill up as much of the screen as I can and with the gray card, and I'm going to take a picture, making sure that I've captured practically all the light coming from all the different sources. So it can be a realistic representation. What I mean by that is obviously that's covering some of the light and that's probably more accurate because I'm getting the external light and the LED light. So the first thing is first, I'm going to take a picture. There you go. And I'm also going to take a picture of the table so we can do a comparison. So now that I've actually got my white balance ready to go, what I'm going to do is I am going to go into the menu and I am going to change it from auto white balance to custom white balance. And below the custom white balance selector, I've got a custom white balance option, which I choose. And now what it does, it allows me to select the image that I'm going to use as my sample for the custom white balance. So I'll scroll back one picture and I am going to use this one. And so it's just a matter of pressing the set button and then okay. And now you've set your white balance to the new setting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a second picture. So we can compare it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch it over to video. Now, in the video, the good thing about the M50 is to set your white balance. It's in exactly the same place. So hit the menu button. And as you can see, it's remembered what I've done in the camera shooting mode. So there's a correlation between video mode and shooting mode. So don't forget that if you set a custom white balance and then you switch over from video to picture, it will retain your white balance settings. So make sure you keep that in mind when you're switching over from one mode to another. And so really that's it. So what I'm going to do now, that is the way now it's going to record. It's just a matter now hitting the record button and it's off and capturing. Now it's a little bit darker than the other mode because I've got it on manual movie mode and I've got an ND filter on. So it looks a bit darker than the pictures, but that's it. That's how easy it is. Take a picture with the gray card held as close as possible with a good representation of the lighting. Take the picture and then use that picture to set it as the custom white balance sample. And that's it. And there you have it, friends, setting your custom white balance on your Canon M50. Hopefully you found this video useful and you keep coming back to the channel for future videos just like this one. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. And until the next time, ciao for now. I hear